Scandinavia. Today I'm going to make a traditional Danish meatloaf called forloren har, or translated it would be mock hare. And it is pork, beef, bacon, onion, eggs, milk, breadcrumbs, flour, salt and pepper. And then we serve it with a gravy and your choice of vegetable and potatoes, of course. Here you see the ingredients for our forloren har. I have a pound of beef, a pound of pork. I have about 6 to 8 slices of bacon. I have a large onion, which I'm going to grind. You can chop it if you like. I have 2 eggs. I have salt and pepper to your choice. I use about 1/2 teaspoon of salt and 1/4 teaspoon of pepper. About 1 cup of milk and 2 tablespoons of breadcrumbs, 2 tablespoons of flour, and I have a little bit of garlic as well, 1 clove of garlic. So I'm going to mix it all up now. Add the eggs. Okay, I'll pour some of the milk in. And I will not add all of the milk right away because I don't want it to be too thin. And here we go with the flour. I added the breadcrumbs. Now I'm adding the pepper and the salt. And the bacon I'm going to put on top of the meatloaf, but I'll show you how I do that. So I have mixed all the ingredients carefully. I only need to add the onion, which I have been grinding, and also a little bit of garlic. If you don't care for garlic, you don't need to have that in there. Okay, so now mix the onion into it, and then after this I'm going to shape it in the pan here, and I'm going to add the bacon on top. So I'll pour the meat in here and I'm going to shape it so it looks kind of like a loaf. Here we have the last few pieces of bacon on top. I'm going to put the meatloaf in the oven and brown it for 15 minutes at the degree of 425. And after that, I take it out of the oven. I add the rest of the milk to the pan, and then I bake the meatloaf for another 1/2 hour at 325. So the meatloaf is in the oven. Like I said, I'm leaving it there for 15 minutes. Then I add the remaining milk and I finish it at 325 for about 1/2 hour. Well, the meatloaf has been in the oven for about 15 minutes. I lower the temperature to 375 and I'm adding the rest of the milk. And now I'm leaving it in there for another 1/2 hour at least. And of course, I wanna also make sure that the bacon gets down, you know, brown. Okay, I am going to pour the meat juices from the pan into a pot and I'm going to make a gravy. And while I'm making the gravy, I'm going to put the meatloaf back in the oven to make sure that I get the bacon all brown and cooked. I forgot to tell you that I had added a bay leaf to the pan. Anyway, it's in the gravy now. I'm adding bouillon cube dissolved in water because I want to make sure I have enough gravy for everybody. And also I'm adding a tablespoon of currant jelly to the gravy. And of course you can serve currant jelly on the side of the meatloaf as well. And I normally in Denmark we would add some coloring, and I have a little bit of coloring here to add. If you don't have that, you know, you don't need it. And then I'm going to thicken the gravy with some cornstarch. Okay, I'm also adding a little cream to the gravy and let it cook for a couple of minutes. So here you see our finished meatloaf. So here we have my dinner ready and I am getting hungry. I have to taste my forloren har, or the Danish meatloaf. We have nice gravy, potatoes. I serve it with peas and carrots today. Yeah, it's very, very good. Mm. So delicious. I really like it. and easy to make and taste delicious. Couldn't be any better. Hopefully you also liked it. Please subscribe to our channel. Thank you.